Hello, this is a stoichiometry video using the ideal gas law. It's from the class Intro to Chemistry, and I'm Fred Oakes. In this video, we'll be doing two things. First, we'll be reviewing the ideal gas law. And then secondly, we'll be applying that ideal gas law to a stoichiometry problem. In other words, it's a stoichiometry problem using gases. Now, the ideal gas law has parts of it that are related to each other. Changing the property of one changes the property of another. Let me give you an example. Let's start with a balloon. If we take this balloon and add gas to the balloon, in other words, we're adding moles, or N, then the volume of the balloon increases, right? You blow air into a balloon, it increases its volume. So changing one thing changes another thing. All the properties are related to each other. Of course, in this case, pressure and temperature are held constant. Now, the ideal gas law can be rearranged depending on what parts we need to know. For example, let's say we need to know volume. To know volume, we need to know moles, R, T, and P. So V is equal to nRT over P. Alternatively, we might want to know moles. If that's the case, we divide both sides by RT. So N moles is equal to PV over RT. The units here on the bottom are atmospheres, liters, moles, and kelvins. Okay, let's get to some stoichiometry. All stoichiometry starts with a chemical reaction. Here's a balanced chemical reaction where we have acetylene reacting with oxygen to form water and carbon dioxide. The problem we'll be using with this reaction is as follows. If we have 3.5 liters of acetylene, we react it with enough oxygen gas, how many liters of carbon dioxide are produced? Let's put the parts in place that we already know. We know that we have 3.5 liters of acetylene. We also know that we're going to need to know how many liters of carbon dioxide. Since these are gases, we need to know more. We need to also know the temperature and the pressure. Here's the remainder of the problem. The acetylene is at STP, and carbon dioxide will be at 530 Kelvin and 2 atmospheres. Let's take the numbers out of the problem and put them in the right spots. The temperature of the carbon dioxide, 530 Kelvins. The pressure, 2 atmospheres. But what about the temperature and pressure of the acetylene? What does STP mean? STP means standard temperature and pressure. So these are things that are standardized. In other words, they're always the same. The temperature is 273.15 Kelvin. That's 0 degrees Celsius. And the pressure at standard is 1 atmosphere. Great, now we have all the things we need to know to start on this stoichiometry problem. How do we get from the volume and temperature and pressure of one gas to the volume and temperature and pressure of another gas? Well, if you've been following along with stoichiometry, you know that the pathway will be through moles. We're going to take volume, temperature, and pressure, convert it to moles of acetylene. Then we'll use the chemical reaction to turn moles of acetylene into moles of carbon dioxide. And then finally, we'll take the moles of carbon dioxide and turn it into a volume of carbon dioxide using the temperature and pressure. So really, what we're interested here in is solving for N at the beginning, giving an N at the end, and then finally solving for V. It's a three-step process. Step one is changing a volume of acetylene into moles of acetylene, again using the ideal gas law. We'll rearrange the gas law, like we talked about in the first part of this video, so that N is equal to PV over RT. Taking the things we know from the chart above, we'll take 1 atmosphere and 3.5 liters divided by 0.0821, which is R, and 273.15, which is the temperature. Throw it in your calculator and you get an answer, 0.1561. Now that we have a mole, we've completed the first step of our operation. We've gone from volume of acetylene to moles of acetylene. What's the next step? Well, we use the chemical reaction to get there. Step number two is moles to moles. We're going to take moles of acetylene and convert it into moles of carbon dioxide gas. To do that, we'll use Fred's famous fudge factor, a pretty shortened version of it, though. We know how many moles of acetylene we have, and we want to cancel out the moles of acetylene, so we put that on the bottom of the next chart piece. Moles of acetylene is converted to moles of carbon dioxide, so we'll put moles of carbon dioxide on the top. The numbers that go in place here come from the chemical reaction. That's the coefficients that are in front of each of those things. So the coefficient in front of acetylene is 2. So we put the 2 by moles of acetylene. And the coefficient in front of carbon dioxide is 4. So we put 4 in front of moles of carbon dioxide. Okay, that's actually the entire calculation there. We're going to take 0.1561 moles of acetylene times 4 moles of carbon dioxide divided by 2 moles of acetylene. And we get an answer. The answer is twice as much as the first step, 0.3122 moles of carbon dioxide. So if you look at how we've gotten so far, We've solved for moles of acetylene, then we've solved for moles of carbon dioxide, and now if you look at the right side of the screen, we've only got one thing we need to know left. That is to say, we need to know volume. So that's the third step, moles to volume. To do that, as you might expect, since it's a gas and we have three of the four things, we're going to solve for the fourth thing. We're going to use the ideal gas law to solve for V. Okay, let's take the numbers and plug them in. We've got moles, 0.3122. We've got R. R is always constant, always the same number. We've got T, and we've got P. There, all of our pieces are in place. Now all that's left to do is put it in the calculator. The answer then is 6.79 liters. And we are now complete with the stoichiometry problem using the ideal gas law.